This is pupa.
Pupa.
Cool, here we go. I feel guilty.
What's up, guys? My name is Nikhil and you're watching Menu Please, the show where we go around the city and try the best Indian food. Now, guys, this episode is a little bit different. Usually on this show, we take our guests to restaurants to try a particular dish. But this time, we brought the cultures of these states to us. That's right, I'm talking about Kashmiri and Assamese cuisine. Today, our guest is one of the pioneers of the modern Indian stand-up comedy scene. He's done everything from movies to music to TV shows to commencement speeches to speeches on commodes. And soon, he's releasing his third special on Netflix. I don't even need to say who it is, but let me just say, we're very excited to have him on. That's all.
Huh, okay. Welcome to Comedians in Innovas, heading to bungalows.
To eat a Rogan Josh. I have to say, Veer, it is an absolute honor to be here with you. I've infiltrated this online comedy scene very recently. It's been just 2 years, but almost every other person I meet says like they've either worked with you, worked for you, or they've referenced you or your content in some way. So
I've slept with a lot of people.
Oh,
just throughout the years. That's been my path.
So is that where tonight is leading? You've grown up in many cities, yeah. And you're currently touring all over the world.
Yeah.
What are like the flavor profiles that you remember that evoke this nostalgic sense in you?
It's a very well phrased question. Oh. And you said I had an illustrious career.
I feel British, my colonial.
I feel like I owe you a sexual favor at the end of this because
it all adds up eventually.
So I sleep with a lot of people.
Oh. Okay, flavor memories. From Nigeria, we had something called suya.
Suya.
Suya is skewered beef.
Mm-hmm.
And you get it on the beach. So suya had this like yellow masala that they would put on the beef.
Hmm.
You will shit in under 10 minutes after eating, but best.
Hmm.
From America, just get like pastrami sandwiches or ham and cheese sandwiches. Hmm. You know, like diner sandwiches. Yeah. We'll do that. For India, my jam is double mutton, single egg, Nizam roll from Middle Circle, Connaught
Place. Holy fuck, that's specific. All right, Veer, you have tantalized my taste buds. And we have reached our first destination. Are you ready to have some amazing, delectable Kashmiri cuisine?
Yes. I'd like to have all of those adjectives separately. You know what I mean?
After a long drive, we've reached Srinagar. Guys, we're actually in a bungalow in Bandra.
Yeah.
Have you been to Kashmir before?
My annual ritual is I'll go to Leh.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll get an Enfield and stay in a tent by the river and just kind of switch cell phones off and I'll do 10 days by myself.
We have a fabulous spread in front of us.
Okay.
And the person who made it is right here, Jocelyn. So can you tell us a little bit about all of these dishes?
So today what we have here is mostly the Pandit cuisine.
Okay.
Except for the fish, everything else that you have at the table, no onion, no tomatoes and no garlic.
That's great.
Yeah. This is the Pandit Rogan Josh. So you'll ask me what are the key ingredients. It's just 4 to 5, which is the hing, the asafoetida, the sund and the sauf. You either top it up with almonds, saffron. Mm. Then the nadru is cooked in. So we have a yakhni gravy, which is the curd based gravy.
Mm.
The nadrus are the lotus stems. So it's a bit of an acquired taste.
Mm-hmm.
So it itself does not have any taste.
Can I ask you a few more questions?
Yes,
if that's okay.
Yes.
You have family in Kashmir?
Yes, lots.
Are you in touch with them?
Awkward silence.
So like you'll be looking forward to having this meal with them soon?
I'm trying.
I hope so.
Yeah.
I hope that happens.
Yeah.
You know?
I've heard that Kashmiri Pandits love their meat.
Yes.
And they love to eat it even during festivals.
Yes, they would offer it to gods also.
You'd offer god meat?
Not offer like if there's not I offer like that.
If I was a god, I'd appreciate like that more than anything else. I just want to tell you. Like,
yeah, me too, I think. You
guys laddu vaddu le aaye, ye dekho mutton le aaye.
Meetha meetha khilate rehte ho thoda abhi.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Jocelyn.
How are you? Have you tried this Rogan Josh?
It's damn good, dude.
It has blown my mind. It is so flavorful. I can taste so much spice.
Okay, I just tried the aloo. The aloo is very good. Come on, try it. Idhar andar kuch hai, aisa jaan hai.
Yeah, they prepare it differently. They poke it with toothpicks so that the curry seeps in. Alright, so this is our final dish. It's nadri yakhni. It's
the
lotus stem. Do you have some already? Oh, you do?
Yeah.
She said eat it last. Is it like dessert?
No.
You said that very fast.
It's not sweet.
Oh, that's different from what I expected.
Oh.
The lotus got you?
The lotus stem got me. It's fibrous and it soaks in the yeah. flavor and the masala.
Yeah.
Okay, we've had a large spread, Veer.
Yeah.
What is your favorite dish?
My favorite dish is a tie between the meat and the aloo.
Ooh, the meat and the aloo. Mine's the meat, hands down. On that note, are you ready to head to our next delicious spread?
My God. And what is our next delicious spread?
Assamese cuisine.
Let's go to Assam.
What's the craziest stand-up stories you've had? Have you met any of your idols?
Going into like an international comedy festival and they're like, he's the guy from India. You know what I mean? And I'll be on a lineup show with a lot of them. Because you're the new guy, you'll go first. At like Montreal, at the festival, there's a show called Midnight Surprise.
Okay.
Where you don't know who the lineup is.
Okay.
And if you're the new guy, it begins at midnight and everybody's smashed.
Oh, right? No.
So on this show is just fucking hard hitter legend. And because I'm the new guy, they're like, you close the show. Indian accent for French Canadians.
Oh, no.
Smashed at 155 after legit legends. You know what I mean? So when you go into the lineup and they're like, are you the new guy? And they're all kind of laughing to themselves. They're like, oh man, I'm sorry. Rite of passage. You got to go through this. We all did. And then at like 155, they're like, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for your headliner? Right? So, so, and everybody's just going, oh, poor guy, right?
Oh my God.
And then I have to go up with like an Indian accent at 155, but I killed.
Fuck yeah.
Because it's an edgy show, so like, and you kind of have to go hard.
Mm-hmm.
And then to have that group of comics kind of be like, all right, let's go have a beer now. Because now you're not the Indian guy, now we need to talk. You know, so that's kind of nice to have. That's my takeaway.
Why do I feel more patriotic than I have in so long? That makes me so happy. Yeah, I don't know why. You performed stand-up in America. Yeah. It was hard at times, but you were bit by the bug.
Yeah.
You brought it back to India. What is it like bringing the scene into India?
You know, a lot of people are like, how did it feel to start the, you know, some legacy? Fuck that.
So if to you, it doesn't feel like you kickstarted modern.
Chappelle's 30 years in. Bill Burr's 30 years in. Mm-hmm. Kevin Hart's 25 years in. Chris Rock's 27 years in. They're great now. 20 years in, you know who you are. I'm 12 and a half years in, man. So I don't know what kind of artist I'm going to be 2 years from now. So there's no legacy yet.
You say you always create the poster without any premise or any stand-up material
then
written.
I have to work backwards from
it. You have to work backwards.
I book an auditorium.
Isn't that scary?
If you're not scared, you're not really evolving, no, as an artist, if you're not petrified of what you're doing tomorrow.
Has this led up to now, like even when you're doing your Netflix special?
No, this date kind of changed. I was supposed to have this come out when it came out, and then I did it.
Okay.
So they're hoping that people will spend Republic Day with me doing non-stop jokes about India for the better part of 70 minutes. It'll be interesting. This might be my last Innova ride.
Well, Veer, we've continued our long car journey into the northeast now.
Yes, we have.
Okay, so we have a very different spread from what we had before. There's a lot of dishes I can't even identify. But luckily, the person who's made this is another home chef and she's from Assam. Let's bring in Geetika to talk a little bit about this food.
This is something very special.
Ooh.
This is a black rice cake.
Black rice kheer?
Yes.
Ooh, and we had this before?
So traditionally in Assam, the Assamese food, we eat all the sweet things before food. So today's spread is all about, primarily about the tribal cuisine. Because we have black sesame chicken, then we have pork with laihak. Laihak is not your rye from here. These are like really huge mustard greens.
Okay.
You have the sari traction, which is the silkworm pupa.
This could have been a shirt.
This could have been a Mysore sari. See, this is the thing.
Yes.
Like, we don't get credit for being like as non-vegetarian as we are.
Yeah, no?
But yes, we do eat a lot of vegetables thanks to the geography.
Now don't bail on me, Adipika. Aisa itna, itna achha
love
this point kiya
love
mene. So we're starting with the black rice kheer.
Look at this. It's so colorful.
It's extremely simple. It's nutty.
It is.
It has really to like be kacha only.
The rice is nice because there's like so much bite to it.
Family's back in Assam?
Yes, they are.
How are they doing?
They're doing good, yes.
Yeah. You're in touch with them and all of that stuff. Everybody's safe, everybody's secure.
Yes, thank you so much.
Great.
Enjoy your meal.
Thank you so much.
Alright, Veer, how do you want to tackle this?
Shall we start with the, what was this, blackened chicken? Huh? Black sesame chicken.
Blackened chicken.
Cool. Here we go.
I'm very nice, excited. Yo.
Factory very good.
Oh, that is so yum. This should be a regular thing all over. Taste of sesame is so strong. I love it. Meat is cooked so tender.
Yeah.
Eat it with the rice. It's almost like sticky rice.
And this is all from her farm, huh? No, rice is good as well. Alright, and this is the pork, right? This is what I'm most excited about. But you're saying it has ghost chili.
Both jalokia. I just translated. Thanks. Wait, sorry.
So, you do work for Netflix. It's literal subtitles.
It's the spiciest chili.
It's the oh really?
Yeah.
Who's your pick right now?
This is my jam.
Chicken
right
hands
now.
Down. Also, strangely enough, the rice.
Yeah.
There's something very cool about this rice.
It's like Indian sushi. Veer, I've had two amazing meals with you. I feel like we got to know two cultures a lot better.
I think so.
I had the opportunity to watch your special ahead of time before its release.
Yes.
So what was the thought process that went behind this special and the way it looks?
I didn't want it to feel like a comedy special at all. I just wanted to feel like a conversation about India. Like you and me would sit and have a cup of chai and we talk about our country. That's what this one was. It's very simple. It's if I could tell you four things about my country, we'd agree on three of them, that definitely they belong in the list. And we probably disagree on one of them. And that one's just for me. If you are reading stuff, read the Vedas, you know, because that's the beginning of our literature. Read the Satanic Verses, because that's the most famous, you know, controversial book to come out of India. Read Tinkle Comics, because they ain't nothing like fucking Tinkle Comics. And for me, read our national newspaper, because it's great fiction. So it's how I feel about my country.
It's one of those specials where you wrote it as a love letter to India, but I feel like all of us can relate to it.
I hope so. Yep. Either that or I'm shit at love letter.
It was tear-jerking towards the end, I'm not gonna lie.
And the nudity didn't bother you at all?
No, it encouraged me. It encouraged the tears.
And the fact that the biscuit was there with the nudity, that didn't like bug you out at all?
That improved the overall experience for sure. Anyways guys, V Special is coming out soon. It's coming out on Republic Day,
yes.
January 26th. I'm super excited.
Thank you.
Guys, be sure to leave a like on this video, share it with your friends, comment what cuisine you think we should try next, and be sure to subscribe to the Netflix India YouTube channel.
If you say mean things in the comment, I will find you. I'll find your family. I'll fuck you up.
I'll feed you bhoot jalokia.
My granddad started out as a policeman. After that, he left and went to the IAS. Then he joined the IFS. Then he was chairman Airports Authority. Then he was chairman of Air India. Then he got a Padma Shri. I tell dick jokes.
Like, wait, what?